So, as you know, in many videos, I have spoken about quantum consciousness. And many people ask, what is the implication, or what are the implications of understanding quantum consciousness? So, in my mind, consciousness, understanding consciousness and the model of quantum consciousness actually helps us understanding quantum biology, quantum effects like entanglement and superposition could explain phenomena in the brain, such as synaptic activity or neurotransmitter behavior. Also, quantum consciousness introduces the idea of quantum uncertainty, which is a potential for free will, contrasting with deterministic models. There are philosophical implications of understanding consciousness because if we understand consciousness, we can understand both mind and matter as dual aspects of a deeper reality, reshaping debates on materialism and dualism. Of course, critics say that there is no empirical evidence, there's lack of empirical validation for quantum consciousness and also for what we can call understanding brain-mind interactions. And this has been a source of criticism of me as well, because I have stated that consciousness can give us access to a deeper understanding of mind and body. However, my critics have constantly assailed me for saying there is no empirical evidence for anything that I'm saying. So here's my response. Consciousness, as understood in Advaita, is without cause. It has no empirical evidence as classically understood. However, it is the basis of all empirical evidence. So I know this is, in a way, a challenge to classical scientific paradigms. But let me explain in detail what I mean. Consciousness is fundamental, and in this framework, consciousness is not the result of physical interactions or brain processes, but is instead a primary aspect of existence, akin to space-time or energy. In fact, it is that which makes known to us the concepts of space-time and energy. It is beyond cause. Classical science relies on causality. Every experience has a cause. However, if consciousness is without cause, it exists outside this framework. In fact, it exists outside of space-time, non-local. And if we understand this, then consciousness has no empirical evidence, but is the precondition for all empirical evidence. Right? Empirical evidence relies on observation and measurement. However, observation itself requires an observer, a conscious entity capable of perceiving and interpreting data. Consciousness, therefore, cannot be reduced to empirical methods because it precedes and enables those methods. While neuroscience can map activity correlated with mental states, which is called the easy problem, it cannot explain why we have first-person experience in the first place. But quantum consciousness actually calls, this is what people like David Chalmers call the hard problem, but if you really understand consciousness, there's no heart problem, okay? Because the heart problem assumes matter as the ontological primitive. And if you actually understand that consciousness, the ground of being, then the heart problem is a non-problem based on the superstition of matter. So consciousness, being inherently subjective, resists measurement. And what I'm saying or suggesting is a new framework integrating quantum mechanics on non-material philosophies to understand the primacy of awareness of consciousness. Because all scientific inquiry begins with quantum conscious awareness. Without a conscious observer to ask questions, interpret results, or even define what constitutes evidence, science could not exist. So also in quantum physics, the role of the observer is central. For example, in wave function collapse, and many interpretations suggest that consciousness is what plays the role in shaping reality at a fundamental level. If what I'm saying is true, then that would mean that consciousness is not a passive observer, but actually the active participant, or actually active agent in the creation of empirical reality. And if we actually understand this, we will also understand the limits of reductionism. Quantum consciousness and its understanding challenges reductionism, the belief that complex phenomena can be explained by their simpler components. If consciousness is irreducible and causeless, reductionist approaches will always fall short in explaining it. And if consciousness underpins all empirical evidence, then reality itself might be better understood as a mental or experiential construct rather than an objective external world. So this has practical implications. It would inspire new models of inquiry that integrate subjective experience with objective observation. And it could lead to advances in artificial intelligence or brain-computer interfaces, which would require rethinking how machines could emulate or interact with human-like awareness. And recognizing consciousness as fundamental could lead to greater respect for all forms of life and deeper exploration into spiritual practices aimed at understanding awareness itself. So please consider, I'm saying this to my critics, please consider the idea that consciousness is without cause and yet the basis of all empirical evidence. And please pay attention to this idea, which challenges traditional scientific paradigms while opening doors to profound philosophical and even scientific inquiry. What I'm saying is that this idea could expand our understanding of reality beyond what classical science is making us aware of. So in this framework, consciousness is not an emergent property, but the most fundamental aspect of existence. So please explore with me that it's not just what we observe, but who or what is doing the observing is a major question that science needs to address. So these are some of the practical implications of understanding quantum consciousness. Take care, my friends.